Hi, I am Marlo, and this is my story, No Filter. I'm happy. I'm full. Kasi before the pandemic, I realized that I was looking too much on the outside, on what I can fix, that I forgot what really matters, and that is my inner being. And I found myself completely nung nag-start yung pandemic up to now. As a son, I guess you know the story about my mom. I really love my parents, and I'm willing to give everything just to, you know, make them happy. And unfortunately, my mom left us almost 3 years ago. I'm not perfect as a son, but I could say that I'm 100% when it comes to the effort that is willing to be put para sa pamilya namin. I'm a fun friend, I could say. I do really love and care about my friends. And I am very much aware kung yung gusto nila individually, so I really try and cater to that and just make them happy. Iba na yung routine ko ngayon. Talagang I really get in touch with myself and keep myself motivated. I read a book. I don't read books prior to the pandemic, but I read books. They're very helpful. And then as much as I can, sa hapon I study, sa gabi I stream. And in between, I really do my music. Last year, I was releasing songs weekly. I had a collaboration with an international star, American Idol finalist Evelyn Cornier. Na ako lahat yung nag-produce. So I was producing my own vlogs. It was really getting a high engagement. But after that, nagpakain ako sa mga thoughts ko. And that's the reason why I diverted my attention sa pag-stream, because it's on the spot, so I get to connect with people. Pinag-aaralan ko ngayon, actually, yung mental health. I'm very passionate about advocating for and knowing the scientific side of it. They should just acknowledge, first of all, diba, our brain is an instrument. It shouldn't be the other way around controlling us. We control our own thoughts and emotions, so one is acknowledge, and second is have confidence within with your self, whole being. It's a perfect balance of everything, not just the mind. It doesn't define us. As long as you are aware of your own weaknesses, kaya ako nasulat yung current single ko na mahina, admitting your weaknesses, it's actually a good sign of strength that you're ready to move forward and live your life. Be in the present moment, ain't a number one. Huwag kayo ma-stuck sa past, and of course, don't dwell too much in the future, lalo na if it's not good. My purpose in life, for me, is to inspire. I study neuroscience sa Harvard online. Ang mga mental health problems, mostly based sila sa false assumptions. Or mga naririnig natin that is, you know, not really who we are. So, once we know the facts that they are just words, and words are very powerful, but you just have to absorb which ones to take in. And the pinaka-importante is to develop self-love. Before, I couldn't get that kung bakit important self-love. You know, maybe it's just being vain or whatever. But I realized na number one yun, because by developing self-love, you learn to take care of yourself even more. You're aware what not to do and what not to apply sa daily life mo, para hindi ka ma-disturb, di ba? Kasi once you fall in love with yourself and with your life, you know what the do's and don'ts, you're gonna treat yourself in a healthier manner. I dedicate this song to my best friend who lives abroad right now. Her name is Kat, and I asked her one day kung ano yung gusto niya ang title ng song. Kasi I promised her na gagawa ko siya ng song last week. She finds comfort and healing sa stars. For me, I want to make it you know, my own, and in our language. So, ang title po ng kanta ko is Between. Very important yung word na liwanag. You're gonna hear that word many times in the song, and ako, I'm very happy right now. I'm at my happiest state because I'm not just happy because I get to go out and get fun, but I'm actually very secure about myself. I know that I have this light within me that I carry around with me, and through my songs, through the words that I extend to other people, yung shine or yung liwanag nag-extend din sa kanila. Yung panahon na my mom was sick, of course I was doing everything I can to keep her alive, pero ayun din yung panahon ng peak ko when I was out there. I wanted fun kasi I was really hoping that she would live a longer life. I didn't think na it's possible pala that she would leave us right away. So regret ko is not spending too much time with her, lalo na nung kailangan niya ako. So kung ano man yung nangyari with my mom, I know I have regrets, but I know that her spirit will live on. And what she wants to happen also is for me to be happy, genuinely happy, and that's what I'm feeling right now. I can say that I am super in love. Super in love with life. And everything, you know, that I have. Kasi I get to appreciate all the simple things that I have even more. Just waking up each day, you know, alive and getting to experience life in its entirety. So it's a favorite word ko yung entirety, because sometimes we get to forget that ang laki-laki ng mundo. It's not just the world that we create in our minds, especially ngayong pandemic na stuck tayo sa mga thoughts, sa mga loneliness, fears, di ba? Hindi natin na-realize na if you just have an overview of life, ang late-late na mga pinaproblema natin. Ang laki-laki ng mundo, and there are many reasons to be happy. And you know, one is being connected with everything, nature, the people around you, music. Akala ko nung panahon na yun, I was stable. I was secure about myself, pero hindi pala. I was surrounded with so much noise, unnecessary noise, na ngayon nagawa kong i-tone down and i-exercise yung creativity ko. Kasi I realized na isa din talaga na meron ako is a creative mind. I could write songs in an instant and I could create something in an instant. Pero naging downside din yun, masyado akong nag-focus sa mga thoughts na hindi naman totoo. So it's always have this grasp of reality. Live life to the fullest. Ayun yung ano ko yun, nakalagay sa Instagram ko yun. Live Scutare, a deep lover of life. Hindi ko aakalain na magkakaroon ako ng matinding anxiety. And everything changed from that point in my life na na-open yung mind ko. And sobra din akong nag-enjoy mag-aral. Kasi yun nga, I'm studying Fundamentals of Neuroscience, Harvard Online. And the other one is Music Technology sa Adelaide. And another one is Voice Technology sa Berkeley. Hindi ko alam na magiging mahilig ako magbasa. Pero yung mga hindi ko akalain na nangyari ngayon, I'm happy that they all happened. So in 5 years, I don't know, but I do have a goal. I'm positive that it will all work out. So my fans, alam nyo, sobrang salamat. You don't know how much you've helped me. Yung support and love I received ko from you guys, isa yung sa main reason kung bakit ako nakaka-survive in life. Ang dami ko nakikita na natulungan ko din pala sila in my own little way by sharing my experiences. And yung experiences na yon and the wisdom na yon, it's not a one thing, it's a two-way. I get to also learn from them. You know, if you just spread love and do everything for the love, then ayun din ang babalik sa'yo. I believe in that. And to my friends and family, I am so, so, so blessed to have you guys. Kasi if not for you, you know, for that, the times that I was at my lowest, you were there to understand me. You were there to keep on pushing me, to pull me. I have nothing but a heart filled with gratitude for you guys. I do love each and every one of you, and in what whichever way I can, you know, that I'm also here for you guys. Salamat, mahal ko kayo. To my mom, I have a lot to say to you, but I just want to thank you for being a big, big part of who I am. Hindi man naging perfect in life natin, but I know you were able to give your best as a mother. And yung mga good attributes ko na nakikita ng ibang mga tao, I know that came from you. Being kind-hearted, senyo ni daddy, being kind-hearted, having this integrity and gratefulness, you know, sa lahat ng mga tamasa. We were living a simple life, so I know if you were here, mommy, you would be super happy and super proud, and I would have loved to experience life with you even more and have this journey around the world, travel na hindi natin masyado nagawa. But with that time that God has given me, I know that it was a life well lived and loved. So thank you, mommy. I love you. My new single, Between, will finally be released on July 16, 12 midnight. So abangan nyo po yan. It's gonna be out on all digital music platforms, including Spotify, Apple Music. July 15 ng 8 PM, re-release po yung music video ng Between na sinoot namin sa Batangas. And for sure, magliliwanag ang buhay niyo.